My name is Mario Rosenau. I'm co-owner, and this is Mike DeMasi. We're co-owners of Art Junkies Tattoo. We started in about 2001. About 2004 is when stencil stuff started out. And so I've been doing that now for, what is that?
11 years.
Almost 12 years now. And my partner in that is Mike DeVries, who owns Indie Tattoos. Who was supposed to be here and stuff, but something happened, he wasn't able to be here. So obviously, Mike was able to step in and help out with the seminar. So, stencil stats, like my main thing, and we started this many years ago, obviously at that time, there really was only, you only had deodorant, Dettol, and it was like not really
sanitary.
There was many things that were wrong with that process. And stencil stuff kind of started by kind of a mistake. It was based off of a home remedy of melting down deodorant and some of those things. But a lot of the chemicals that are in deodorants, and they've changed over the years. Even a lot of the deodorants you see now, antiperspirants, they've gotten away from a lot of the chemicals that are in there because they're harmful. So, but we used to make this, and I had played around with some different things, you know, little experience in college, chemistry, and some of that, enough to make myself dangerous. Not that I really knew a whole lot, but started making it, and it was, you know, kind of by trial and error. Well, it became this thing where the guys in the shop would say, hey, can I use some of that stencil stuff? There was no name for it. It was just something that we all did. And that's kind of how it became. And then that's kind of how the name became, because that's what everybody in the shop would call it. It kind of got started a little bit on a challenge, you know? But I really saw like an opportunity, like, you know, at Art Junkies, like, it was our main goal has always been to have an impact on the industry from an artistic standpoint, from a teaching standpoint, which Mike is probably one of the greatest teachers in this industry. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you guys know a lot of the people that have come through there and started there. I play a part in that, but I mean, I have to give hats down to Mike on that. And he's going to share a lot of his thoughts about making a stencil, theory about placement, how to, you know, get the most out of it. I'm going to go over a little bit about the products and how they're used, and show you a couple things that are brand new that are coming out that are going to be game changers. We've been using a few things, but we're kind of going to focus a lot more on some of the tattoo aspects of it, and in regards to a stencil, making a stencil, some placement and some of that. But again, the main motto has always been creating a professional product for professional tattoo artists. I took this, there was a long journey. It was at that time, there wasn't a lot of products out there. And it kind of has become, there's a lot of other products that have popped up. And you know what, honestly, it's flattering. You know, it's flattering. Because they're all referred to as stencils, so it's like Kleenex. Well, I mean, I don't know how many companies make tissue, you know? And everybody's trying to improve, and it's good because it pushes us to try to improve and stuff. But I think a lot of people don't realize that we have a lot of products, and we have a lot of things that we're working on to make it better, you know? And I don't try to get fixated too much on what everybody else has done. If somebody's doing something that I think is pretty awesome, like, good, let's go in this direction and try to solve a problem for somebody else. And we love hearing feedback from people, you know? But, you know, stencil stuff is, you know, we have a chemist who's, he's been about 45 years in the skincare industry. He does stuff for Clinique, Estee Lauder. He was a co-founder of Hawaiian Tropic. He has a tremendous amount of experience. And through this, we've learned. So for us, we've always stayed ahead of the game. And we're gonna talk a little bit about some of the stuff that's kind of going on with the FDA and regulations. We've seen a lot of stuff in Europe with the EU, and they've really hammered down on the tattoo industry. We've seen it a lot with the inks, and we've always stayed ahead of the game on that. The testing that goes on, this stuff is not made in a garage. It's not made in our facility. It's made in a lab, you know, where they make, you know, multi-million dollar brands that you see out everywhere. So you can have a lot of confidence that this stuff is of the highest quality, you know. I'm not saying that the other brands out there aren't. I don't know, but I know, I can tell you that the stuff that we do is, you know, top of the line. And following guidelines that are not even a part of the industry yet, but may be coming, so.
I think stencil stuff has always been, like, tried and true, you know what I mean? It was like one of those things that, you know, when he first started it, like, everybody got to try just to see. And like, even the stuff they do now, like, it goes through a procedure where, like, I mean, we're working with stuff for months before it even touches anybody else's hands, you know what I mean? I'm not part of stencil stuff, but I've been there from day one, you know what I mean, trying it. And it really filled a void when we first started doing portrait stuff, because everybody's tattoos would wipe off, their stencils were gone, you know what I mean? But like, when we started this thing, it was like, how's your stencil still staying on? Now it's like a staple. Like, you know what I mean? Like, a portrait that was done 15 years ago, like, now that's like rookie stuff, you know what I mean? If you're not doing a portrait like that now, you're getting left behind, you know what I mean? So it's like, the progression keeps going. You know, and stencil stuff has always been one of those one of those companies that like, wants to fix an issue, you know, make tattooing better. You know, and that's like, to me, that's a big deal because that's his brand, and it's like, he's always doing something that's gonna help us make our jobs easier, you know? So when he has a new idea, he's like, hey, try this out, try this out, try this out. And then we'll give him feedback. I don't like it, I like it, it's not that cool. You know what I mean? Sometimes I'm a dick, you know? I'll be honest, I'm like, bro, that thing sucks. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna use it. And it's the same thing, you know? It's like a huge trial and error, and we like feedback from everybody. And, you know, I don't know how many people actually think it's my company, because I go so hard with stencil stuff, you know what I mean? Just because I support him so much, kind of like Intense, you know, it's the same thing. Like, I've been using Intense since I started.
And he is coming on board with some products and stuff that he's gonna be involved with, so.
But I want you guys to ask questions too. Any questions you have, the more questions, the better with anything. Tattooing, stencil stuff, how we do it, why, you know? I mean, have you guys ever used any stencil stuff or?
Absolutely.
You know,
sure.
I mean, and if there's issues with some of them, you know, have you tried the little packets? I don't know if you have the little, the single shots. For some reason, and I mean, this is a debate between Mario and myself and DeVries and myself, the little packets, I think, work phenomenal. Like, they're better than the bottle. And they're like, it's the same shit. And I was like, it is the same shit, but there's something about, I don't know if it's the way it's sealed, but it works really good. Like, if you come in the booth, like, I have these little packets, and that's what I use.
Yeah, and I brought some stuff that I'm gonna give to everybody, but that goes to one of the big things that's happening. You see the single use thing, single use. And it, at some point, they're not gonna want you to have this type of stuff. It's gonna be like single use, you use it, you throw it away, it's done. Well, we've had these packets for a long time, and seriously, we have this debate all the time. And I do see it. It's just a hard thing to grasp your mind around because it's the same stuff. Like, you know.
But it's the same shit with ink though. I mean, I had this conversation with Mario too. Like, Mario Barth, you know. Now, if you look at his ink, this shit doesn't happen. You know what I mean? When you shake the bottle, there's, you know, you can have like this much powder at the bottom of it. But if you don't shake the whole thing, you know, and get all that powder loose, then the ink doesn't work as good, you know. Now he's fixed it, and there's never any ink that gets hard in his bottles, which is crazy. But it's the same thing. Like, if you pour an ink cap full of ink and it's not as good, you shake it, and you get all that broken loose, and the ink's more saturated, you know. So, I mean, I used to get shakers, and I put my ink on a shaker and just let it, you know what I mean, just so I could get, like, the full effect of making the ink perfect, you know. I'm really picky with everything that I do, so. I forgot what I was going to say about stencils. Do you guys have questions about stencils in general?
I have one question.
Yeah.
If you use an actual stencil and then using Sharpie, have you sprayed the Sharpie stencil stuff over
the
regular
over
stencil stuff and it's still not effective?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could. I like to put the stencil on and then put the spray stuff on over it, depending on who I'm tattooing.
Okay.
Now, like, we have, I mean, I know you guys all have tattooed people that, like, have different skin types. You know, some sweat way more than others. Some are
oily as shit.
Some have dry skin. So, like, the stencil reacts completely different. And anytime you put something on, I could put a stencil on you, and it'll be completely different than putting it on him. You know what I mean? So I try to dry out the skin as much as possible, even if they are oily. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
another alcohol pass.
The prep stuff actually was like why this was created.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
Because it was an issue that I was having, you know, and then I'd bring it up, hey dude, I have this issue. Why is my stencil wiping off? And I know how good stencil stuff is. And it's like, well, it's the oils in the person's skin. You know what I mean? So, like, after you clean it, you know, it came up with the product of completely killing everything on the skin, which was, like, took it to a whole nother level. I just wanted something to sanitize it just a little bit more besides alcohol. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because you don't really know. Like, sometimes alcohol's a little too much. Is it really killing everything on the skin? Is it not? So he came back and was like, well, this is what we came up with. And they're like, well, what the fuck is this? And
Are you guys familiar with, like, pH levels in your skin? Mm-hmm. So the thing is, so you, in different parts of the country, in the world, you have different climates. So people's skin is different based upon that climate. Also in places as well, because you'll see that a lot on ribs seem to be troubling, you know. So what we want to do is solve two problems. One is having something that you could actually sanitize the skin. Getting things like, you know, bacteria, MRSA, certain staph strains off the skin. Because really that's how you're transmitting staph to people. If you were, you know, one reason why you would never want to use a Sharpie on somebody else. Sharpie's alcohol-based, so because it's alcohol-based, it does kill certain bacterias, but it also will hold. So why they tell you don't go to the gym, because we all have that bacteria on our skin right now. It's not harmful to us. But if Mike had a cut, Mike had something like this, and somehow he got my sweat or that onto there, and it was the right scenario, his immune system was down, he's gonna have an issue. So how could we prep the skin to make sure that we solve that? That was the first priority. And so the difference between this, and a lot of people will smell it and it's like, yeah, it smells like alcohol. But it's not. It has some oils in here. Because the problem with alcohol is that you drastically change the pH level. So if you spray this down, you're actually stripping out oils that are really important for the healing process later on in the tattoo. So you don't want to do that. So this is very hard, like very mild on the skin. It's not harsh. But it also allows you to get off all the dead skin cells. So again, another thing too is like the way that I watch a lot of people put stencils on, there's a way to do it to ensure that you're gonna have much better stencils. So even if you weren't using this and you're just doing green soap, if you've ever gone and had a shot at the doctors or they go to draw blood, you'll notice the way that when they wipe it with that alcohol, it's kind of hard, and it's down, down, cross, cross. They do this like crossing hatch pattern, and what it's doing is they're getting all that dead skin cells and bacteria like off. And that's what you want to do. You want to strip that stuff off of there. So on prep stuff, the way that I would use it is we spray it on, and I'll do the wiping motion. Okay? Because it does have some alcohol in it, I will then go to a soap them up, and then shave them. And then dry the skin really well. And that's the best method to prepping the area. So I'm sanitizing it, getting all the, you know, I'm basically exfoliating it is what I'm doing. And then putting a soap on and shaving it. Really exciting because Mike's really got to test this out and he's gonna be a part of it, but we have a soap, a wash that's coming out, and it is
it's epic.
It's pretty amazing. I'm gonna pull it out so you guys can see it. It's not in an actual bottle. If any of you guys are tattooing today, I'd be more than happy to bring your wash bottle over. We'll put a little bit in so you can try it. But it literally is almost, I would say it's an alternative to even using an ointment to heal your tattoo. But tattooing with it is absolutely amazing. It is very strong. It's like a industrial strength degreaser, if you will, which is awesome because wiping off ink and stuff, it is so powerful. If you've ever gotten like, you're doing some white highlights and then you go back and do something and you actually get it in bed, this will actually pull any of that ink that washed into your white like immediately out.
Well, it's crazy because like put it in a foamer and you'll spray it on there. It doesn't matter what you're doing, you can have black. And then the whole, you just foam it, you know? You're going like this and your whole tattoo will turn black because it takes all the ink that you're using and it just completely wipes off. Like, you don't get any ink stuck in there. And it's crazy, I literally have people healing in 3 days. Like, what is this shit? You know what I mean? It's fucking, it's unbelievable. But it's the soap. Like, the soap has all these healing agents in it and it just breaks everything down so nice. It takes everything out. Like there's no redness. It's insane. If you guys come and watch,
is it like a green soap, or how would you say
it is? Nothing like green soap, and it's not harsh. Like everybody loves the way it feels. Like there's no burn.
How's your stencils hold up?
Like, now that's an issue. That's an issue for sure. You don't want to use the soap until your stencil's gone. Because you're gonna put that soap on, like you said, it's like a degreaser, and it's gonna take that shit off right away.
Which is really awesome. Which is really awesome because when you do have problems, so like, it was fun in
Kelsey, conflicts like, with stuff itself. It's
so funny because you know, like, you hear, you know, it's the truth. Some people have issues with stencils staying on, some people don't. But it's really funny, like when you have, like, you know, I was in Hell City, a good friend of mine came over and he's like, dude, we did this tattoo yesterday and I got this stencil on me, I can't get it off. And the soap took it right off. And it's super mild, there's no alcohol in it. It works best in a foamer. It's gonna be coming out really soon. We're even going to have some single use. So they look similar to like a Capri Sun container. They're pre-filled with sterile water, the whole thing. You don't have to wrap it. It has a little hose that snaps on it. You can use it and then just throw it away.
That's awesome.
So is it good for re-stenciling, let's say?
Oh yeah.
Extremely. It's like wide spectrum.
Well, that's like when you were saying shaving and stuff, like it's foamy. Like if you use the foamer, it's like you're using, you know, shaving cream.
Have you guys tried it? You know those little purple surgeon markers?
Mm-hmm.
Have you guys tried it with those? Because those things are like hell to get off.
Oh yeah, it'll take anything off.
Yeah?
It's crazy.
But
I mean, that's why it makes the tattoos so clean.
Yeah.
Like, and you can see your colors instantly. And that's what some of them I like about it. Even if like you have somebody who's just really, really red and you can't see the colors at the moment, especially when you're doing like portrait stuff. You know what I mean? Like, you're using flesh tones.
Is it like an oil-based stuff?
Yeah, it's like a plant-based oil soap. So it's like a very natural degreaser that happens in nature all the time. And that's why it's like with a stencil, you gotta be careful or really dilute it down. If you really dilute it down, you're not gonna have issues, but I mean, you really don't wanna like put it over it, you know? But the biggest thing is like getting the ink off. Like, I mean, it just, taking it off when you can't get it off. And we've even tried putting it into a couple drops into a rinse cup, and it just strips the ink right out of the...
Which has got to be really good for
right out of the tube.
Person getting tattooed, being you're not having to wipe it so much to get to that clean level.
And honestly, like, I don't know if you guys ever use a foamer when you're tattooing, but like, so much better, so much more gentle. Like, on the skin, you don't have anybody complaining, you know? And like, back on the portrait thing, you know, when you're wiping it, you're seeing those colors instantly, especially if you're like, your flesh scale is like from a 10 to a 0, and it's like almost all the same scale of colors, you know what I mean? But you can see the blend all the way through. It makes it so much better, because sometimes you can't see that blend until it's healed, or, you know, the redness is gone. But when the redness is gone right away, you can saturate it more, you can see, like, you can build it up a lot easier, you know? And there's a lot of times I'll just spray it on there with a paper towel and just let it sit like on the bottom, you know, while I'm working. So like if I'm working on this piece here, the soap is just staying on the paper towel. And then by the time I lift up the paper towel, all those colors are just pop through. You know, it's super rad. You should, you know, if you get the chance to try it today, you should try it.
What's it called?
We don't know yet.
Like I said, it's been like one of those things that I've been using for at least a year now. And the guys in the shop, you know, finally, you know, they've been using, like, I need more of this. I don't want a tattoo without it. It's like,
I mean, it's...
Yeah, me neither.
It's, you know, we've had tons of it in the shop. We come back in, and I'm like, oh, I got to grab some because I have to take it over here. And it's like, it's empty. Sorry, bro, we used it all. I was like, you know, I don't...
We're talking gallons, man. Like, I've used the shit out of it. But whatever, it's good.
Not really sure yet. There's a name on the side. It most likely, it's probably going to fall into the redemption line that we have. And I'll talk about that at the end, kind of where redemption fits in with us and stuff. But I'm not really sure.
As far as irritating skin, like green soap, I use Dial to keep the irritation down. Does it actually like soothe the skin?
Like, I mean, I was a huge fan.
And the aftercare, you said you could wash with it.
Yeah, but like,
I know my tattoo. Actually, with I just got this piece for Brett, but the whole time we used the soap for the tattoo, and then I filled it also with a tattoo and a lotion, and it was like night and day difference. Like, seriously, within 3 days, I was completely healed.
Wow.
And it's like, whoa. Like, I get excited about it because you want your tattoos to feel good on yourself, and you want them to feel good on your client. So, I mean, I've had some clients, I mean, that was the biggest part, was I was freaking out, like, I was gonna sleeve, and, you know, I have this couple that they're just determined to get tattooed, so, like, get it done as much as possible, and any cancellation I get, they're like, hit me up. I mean, I tattooed this girl, 3 days later, she came in and got tattooed again, and she was completely healed, and I was able to tattoo over the shit that I tattooed three days prior.
Wow.
Like, and I was like, blown away. I was like, I'm just gonna fucking go for it. I could work on different areas, and I did. You know what I mean? And then I was like, well, I'm gonna touch this up a little bit or hit this spot. And she was absolutely fine. You know what I mean? And then she even got to the point where it's like, hey, could I clean my tattoo with it? So I was like, sure. I put a little in the bottle and gave it to her, you know? I mean, Mario doesn't know I was giving it away, but like, I'm crazy about that shit though. Like, I know this sounds bad, even like, I probably shouldn't say this, but like, you know, the Tegaderm wrap, you know, the wrap, we use those also.
We've been using them for
a few years, but at first I didn't like it. I was very skeptical. So I would, you know, like I said, I need to figure shit out. So I'm going to figure it out. I literally overworked people intentionally in certain areas and put the wrap on and wanted to see how it healed. I mean, I would never tell my client that I'm doing this intentionally, you know? But it's like, I'm going to do it in an area that I know I could touch up or I could fix. And I fucking, like, why not? You know what I mean? Let's see how good this stuff really is. It fucking worked. There was nothing wrong with it, you know? And I did the same thing with all of it, you know? The same process. Like, well, let's see if this soap really works. I'm gonna really see what happens. You know, so if your client comes back and shit's fucked up, you'd be like, dude, that's your fault. Because I've really, really tried to mess shit up on everybody else. And it's not working. You know what I mean? So like, I know I'm doing a good job. No, we use Tegaderm. I mean, I didn't like Tegaderm. I don't know if any, but like,
I have it in here.
If there's like Tegaderm people in here, I'm sorry. Like, I didn't like the fact it's not sterile. You know, I think maybe if they make it in a sterile thing, I'd be a little more excited about it. But the Tegaderm one that we use comes in individually wrapped, so everything's sterile. And the other ones, like some of the ones that are on rolls and stuff like that, like, I don't know where it's been. You know what I mean? Yeah. So like, I'm not even gonna try it for the most part. But yeah, I mean, I was giving soap away to my clients just because I wanted to see how fast they can live.
And that's what you need. And that's why we get excited, like when people like put feedback on it. It's funny because, you know, sometimes you get bad feedback on there and people come to our defense and it's awesome. But like, it's good though, because like everybody's opinion actually matters. And that's something that I don't know if everybody really knows. I mean, sometimes you have to put your, you know, you need a hug, you know, afterwards, you know, but it's, you know, people's opinions, you know, like if one guy says something and then another guy says something, another guy says something, you kind of have to go, okay, I have to look at it. Is this really a problem? You know, if one guy says it and then 1,000 people don't say it, then, you know, it probably something else was going on. But I don't ever discount, you know. It's like the goal is that to make better products for all of us, you know.
Well, there's a lot of effort. There's a lot of effort that goes into it that people don't see. You know what I mean? Like the homework that went into everything that's being made. Like, even though, like, I'm not part of this, I've been in the process of all of it. You know what I mean? So I'm like really proud of it. I'm not gonna use something I don't like, you know? Just to give you an example of like how long shit really takes, like we have a lotion, the sunblock, it's called Tattoo. But you know, we were giving it to everybody, try it out, it's a sunblock, because I hate sunblock, you know? And I have like really sensitive skin. So obviously, I went to Mario, I was like, dude, let's do something that's, it's different. You can wear it every day and it doesn't feel like sunblock. I mean, I'm wearing it right now. You know what I mean? And so we did it. It took like 2.5, maybe 3 years. I mean, diligently though, like FDA, all these different testing. Like, we went through so much shit just to get it done. And it was funny because Teresa Sharp, she was using it for a long time and giving it to like her clients. So many people were trying it out. And the biggest complaint that we got was it's blue. Like, the thing's blue, and it's like, I'm laughing at people, because it's blue for a reason. It's blue because it contrasts with 90% of people's skin. And when you're putting on tattoos, you know, like, obviously, you're a little more orange, blue contrast, it makes the tattoos look brighter. There's so much thought that goes into everything that's been processed and everything. You know what I mean? So it's like, oh, it's a little blue. Like, yeah, it's supposed to be blue. You know what I mean? But people don't really understand, like, why, you know? And a lot of that's the same thing, like, we looked in the makeup industry, and a lot of people do it too. A lot of people have really red skin, so like, you know, some of their makeup foundation will be green to contrast with the red skin, you know what I mean? And we've been doing the same thing with tattooing for a long time, like, you know, just because, you know, the picture up here, like, her flesh tones is one way, it's not gonna look that way on everybody's skin. Like, you have to adjust it to people's skin, you know? If like you're orange based, like my flesh tones are gonna be more blue based, so they stand out more, you know what I mean? So like, there's a lot of thought that goes into everything, you know, not just tattooing, but every little product, you know? I mean, from down to the smell, down to like the color, the consistency, you know what I mean?
So you're making that sunblock now?
Oh yeah, we have it now. You know, it's out, it's called Tattoo. We're probably going to change things up a little bit, you know. Probably, we were saying it's probably going to be along the redemption line, you know. I have some. You guys can try it if you want to come check it out. But yeah,
you have the booth.
Yeah. I should have some at the Intense booth too, but it's just to give you an example of like how much stuff really goes into it, you know, and having other people test it. Like I just used Teresa Sharp because it was the first person that came in my head, but there's multiple people that have had their hands on it to try it out, get feedback, see what happens, and then you put it out there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool. I mean, there's a lot of cool things and a lot of thought that goes into it. It's not just a fly by night, like, hey, check this out. Like, you know, to Mario and Mike's credit, like, they really try to do something to change an issue. You know what I mean? Like, if you
serious high standards.
Yeah, like, and I mean, that's what I get proud of. You know what I mean? Like, not to throw Mario under the bus, but like, they've been working on like this armrest thing, and it's fucking rad, but I don't like it. You know what I mean? It's a great idea, and it's like, you know, and I feel like a dick. I felt like a dick because, like, guys, I just don't like it. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think I'd ever tattoo with it. Maybe somebody else would, but I wouldn't. And their response is like, all right, well, how am I going to get Mike to be able to tattoo with it? So let me change my design. Let me, like, rethink how to do it. You know what I mean? Because they're trying to make it work for everybody. You know what I mean? And if I have an issue with it, you know, and it is tough. Like, you could just, you can make it, put it out there, sell it, and make money, and be like, oh, sweet, I made some money, that's fucking rad. But that's not what Stencil Stuff's about. You know, so like, I get proud of that stuff when I do see their stuff. I'm like, all right, cool. Because it really does matter, you know? Like, everything matters. Because it's going to make our job better in the long run. You know?
It's probably going to last longer.
I mean, the idea that I'm talking about is, it's a cool idea, but it's just not perfected.
Yeah.
You know? And I felt bad because they both loved it. You know what I mean? And if Mike was sitting here right now, they'd both probably be fuming and be like, you're a fucking dick. Because there was a lot of thought that went into it, and I shot it.
I mean, it's just one of those things, like, it's important. Like, because if he doesn't like it, I mean, a lot of the people that test our stuff, like, they have an insight. They see the bigger picture. So, and they're honest. Like, that's the one thing you want. You want people to be honest with you. You don't want people to tell you how great you are. It's like tattooing. Like, you know, one of the biggest things in our shop, and it's always been that way, is every guy has to show their tattoo at their neck every single day. Dumb tattoos, it doesn't matter. And gather's like, oh yeah, sweet, awesome. But there's a lot of conversation that goes afterwards, like how you can make it better, how you can do this. And like people like guest spot at the shop, like they freak out, you know, but they get into it. It's like everybody's like connected. And it's the feedback, like how do I get better? How do I, you know, like how do I keep progressing? So with products, it's gotta be the same thing. How do I keep moving forward? How do I progress? I don't wanna regurgitate the same stuff that is already out there. Great, there's so many great ideas I see all the time. There's stuff that I was like, yeah, I had that idea like 3 years ago. Awesome, now I don't have to worry about it. Problem solved for everybody. I can be on to the next thing, you know? Same thing with DeVries, you know? He's, you know, that guy's got a million ideas as well, you know? But we just, you know.
But it's all on making tattooing better, you know? And that's, you know, people ask, you know, what's the difference between tattooing now and tattooing like 10 years ago? And it's like, well, everything, you know, like not only are the artists better, you know what I mean? Like artists, like at this point in tattooing, everybody has the basics down. Like, and if you don't have the basics down, you just gotta bust your ass just a little bit harder, ask a few more questions, and you'll get those basics down quick. Like everybody knows how to do a line. Everybody knows how to shade, everybody knows how to blend, everybody knows how to saturate. And if you don't, like, you'll get it quick because the knowledge is out there. You know what I mean? You could ask anybody and they're gonna help you out with it. Now it's like artistically, how do you separate yourself, you know? And now the products are just making everything better. Like, holy shit, this soap is gonna make my life so much easier. You know, a portrait that took me 6 hours, I'm getting done in 3 hours because I don't have to, like, the redness. You know what I mean? Like, things are just, the healing process is better, you know? The stencil is better. The ink is better, you know?
The machines are better.
The needles, like, you name it, everything's just better. So it's just making the industry grow even more, you know? I had this conversation with Mario Barth last weekend. You know, I was like, the ink is so much better. Like, I've been tattooing it with it since I started tattooing, you know? And he just looked at me and laughed. And I was like, no, it's the same. I was like, no, it's not. It's better. I know it's better. It's different. You know, and he's like, yeah, it is. I was like, yeah. You could tell a difference. Like, everything is progressed, you know, and it's just going to get even better. So it just makes our life easier, you know? Why not? I want all the easy shit. Give me all the stuff that's going to make tattooing better for me.
And then the easier it gets, the more everyone can stand out as their own, you know?
Well, then you could really, the artistic ability starts to show, you know what I mean? Because now everything is on the effort, like, on yeah, it's on an even playing field. Everyone's using the same stuff. Everyone's using the same things, you know? Everybody just now has the opportunity to make their artistic ability shine. You know, before, you know, 15 years ago, a color portrait was unrealistic, you know what I mean? And now everybody's doing a color portrait, and they're doing phenomenal at it. You know what I mean? That's not just like a coincidence. It's like, yeah, the knowledge is out there and things are getting easier, you know? You do paint by numbers. Like, when I show you how to make a stencil, it's like, it's thoughtless. You know what I mean? Like, there's the colors. This is how you do it. Just put it in and go. It's now really just up to you to make it work, you know? Use your artistic approach to make it happen. Yeah. I mean, and proof is in the pudding. Like, I mean, you work hard at it, you're going to get good, you know? We just try to make it easier.
Yeah, I think the less things you have to worry about when you're doing a tattoo allows you to actually put more of that into the tattoo itself to make it a better one.
Yeah. The worst part of my day is setting up and breaking down. You know what I mean? I hate doing both of them. You know what I mean? Like, I wish I could just come in and just go and then leave. You know, like, it all honesty, yeah. And honestly, like, making stencils suck too, you know? Like, I fucking hate that process. Like, I just want to start tattooing. And I mean, I've been working on it for a long time now. I know DeVries has, like, trying to perfect the computer stencil. You know what I mean? And we're getting there to where it's like, this is a portrait, and now this is a stencil. You know what I mean? And now I can just print and tattoo. Yeah, I mean, and it's happening. Like, Mike's been doing it a lot, but like, it's not to the point where like, he's like, he made one for me a few months ago in Palm Springs. He's like, here, man, here's your stencil. I'm like, no, that's not gonna work, dude. I'll do it by hand, you know? And he's like, oh no, look, you know? I'm like, no, I could do it with little stuff like, you know, kanjis and shit like that. I could do it like, and have a perfect stencil off the computer. You know, but when it comes to a portrait or anything realistic, not quite there. We will be.
Did you guys see the post that Mike posted of the video of him doing a digital stencil? And I mean, he wanted to be here today, so like he was gonna show you guys how to do that. But we'll post the video. That's crazy. I don't know how. If I would do it that way, like I would definitely have to do some practice. But like when we were talking yesterday, he was like, I haven't made a hand stencil in over 3 months on any of his stuff. The you know, and it's like, it's crazy. But it definitely is a learning curve on things. And that's where it's gonna go, you know? And like Mike would tell you, like, hey, you know, like, if I have to spend sometimes an hour, sometimes 2 hours making a stencil, like that's an hour or 2 hours that I didn't get paid. Like, so if I can do something that I can do in 20 minutes and then get right to work, it, you know, I'm, you know, better off for them.
If I could do it in a couple clicks, I'll be happy. You know what I mean? But at this moment, it's not gonna happen because you guys all tattoo, so you know like the importance of making the stencil because you're getting familiar with the piece that you're drawing. You know what I mean? Like you just know. You know, like making the stencil, then you go back and you're like, I don't even need to look at it anymore because I just fucking traced it. You know what I mean? Super simple though, but we'll get the computer thing down. And I Photoshop a lot. I don't know if you guys Photoshop, but it's like the greatest tool for tattooers now. Like, you know, I mean, it's funny, everybody wants to say, oh, you guys don't even draw, you don't draw. I mean, I draw my ass off, you know what I mean? But if you can Photoshop a sleeve and put it on somebody's body right away and they can see what it looks like, dude, sold. You know what I mean? If you're trying to convince a client, like, oh, no, you should go a little bit bigger, you should do it like this, you know what I mean? Here, let me Photoshop it real quick. And they're like, oh, that's dope. You're like, yeah, cool, done. You know what I mean? So much easier. If you don't use Photoshop, you should probably start.
Yeah, and I think you see a lot. I mean, I'm sure a lot of you guys do use Photoshop or are starting to take the time to learn it because it's such a time saver. It opens up a lot more of what you can do. But it's so crazy because I remember that was at least 10, 11 years ago, taking a Guy Atchison seminar at Mario's and show in Jersey, and that's what he was telling everybody. And there was like crickets in there, you know? And that's why he's so ahead of the game, you know? And I mean, he definitely does his own thing, but like, he saw that that's where it was gonna go. Now you have tattoo artists in the Wacom booth, you know, opening up a whole nother realm of what can be done, you know? And it's coming, like, the being able to do digital stencils, you know, you're drawing on the computer and then you print it out, and you can do everything, you know, there. So, super exciting, like, the stuff that's gonna happen, you know?
I'm just looking for a picture on show real quick, but you keep talking.
There's like another big thing we have coming out, we've been working on that for like 2 years, is we have our own stencil paper that's coming out. It's been something that, you know, is needed. If any of you guys are here from Europe, you know the problem with some of the stencil papers are not allowed. Our paper got approved on last Friday, and for all intents, it's the same thing that everybody was used to before, minus all the things that the EU wanted out of it. It was a long process, super excited, did backflips. The paper's been ready for a long time and we would have launched it in the US, but I wanted one paper that we could just do everywhere. And so, super excited about that. So that's gonna be coming out. Mike's gonna show you some cool things. This is something, and we'll pass it around. This is the raddest little tool. You can just buy this at Hobby Lobby. It's like one of those stylist.
It's actually made for stenciling?
Made for stenciling, but like for arts and crafts. There's two little balls on the end of it. This is what we make stencils with. We don't use a pen. We don't use a pencil, and the reason we don't is because those marks with the pen, those marks with the pencil, you know, they can get in the way of the information that you're trying to map out on your stencil. And this little guy solves that problem. These come in like a 3-pack. It's the middle size one, seems to be like the perfect size.
Well, it glides on the paper
because it's just a round little metal ball on there.
We use that in art school. It's called burnisher, right?
Yeah. It's just a little burnisher for stencils. Like they'll have like the rub on.
More flat one.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's sweet.
They're probably,
I think it's like $5 for 5 periods. No.
Well, sure. Thank
you. But they're rad because, yeah, you don't have to sharpen the pencil, you don't have to use a pen.
Also, it seems like the printer is not going to use so much ink because you don't have to print out two because you're not marking it all up.
Right. So, like, a lot of times, which is a good point, my next point, too, is that when I do make the stencil, like you refer to your stencil a lot too, you know, and I notice a lot of people, especially like the guys that, you know, come through the shop and when they're first starting and learning, they really rely on that stencil. And they're looking at the stencil that they just made. So they end up putting the marks in their tattoo because they're looking at their reference that they just drew off of. Right. You know what I mean? So like there's like a line in the face that goes this way that they drew to like make, you know, like whatever they're making a shadow or something. And they put it in there and they tattoo it and it's like, fuck, I didn't even realize it did that. You know, with this stuff, you can't even, it's basically you're just pressing. You can see it, but it's clear. You know what I mean? You're not gonna see anything, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's the exact same principle.
You can see the groove in the paper, and you need to reference that line. So
But the cool thing when it gets to you, I mean, it's like, you don't, you know, there's different sizes, so depending on what you're doing. So if you wanted some really fine lines in there, you know, you just flip it to the other side. Like I said, those things come in a pack of three, and there's so there's six different ball sizes on them. But
what you call them?
I think they're called
burnishers
or
B-U-R-N-I-S-H-E-R.
Burnishers or stencilers.
It's called wood and grant making.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
As far as Photoshop, y'all like have a specific like tattoo oriented like how-to video from somebody? I know like DeRees had one. Back in the day, but
DeRees has one that he did with Jamie Parker that works for him. Super amazing.
I think Russ Abbott has one coming out too. Oh, Russ Abbott.
If there's anything you ever want to know about on Photoshop, too, there is YouTube tutorials about everything.
That's basically what I do. Is anything Photoshop. I need on YouTube, but I would like to have something.
Yeah,
you can take a whole school on YouTube.
Straight to. I mean, I've taught myself everything on Illustrator and Photoshop, like from watching YouTube videos and tutorials. And like, if you get the Adobe Cloud, I don't know if you guys got that or. Have it, you know, it's like $50 a month, and you get everything you make. You know, they have endless tutorials too that you could just watch and like
Adobe TV or whatever.
No, it's just like it's their cloud. So like once you pay for their subscription for like Photoshop and Illustrator and stuff like that, it's like a monthly payment, but you get everything. You know,
all their schooling.
You get all the videos.
There's another really awesome website. It's called Digital Tutors. And it's like $30 a month. And it has everything from all like all the Adobe products, Maya, 3D Studio Max, RenderMan, like all these like, you know, AutoCAD, all of these. And it's the full actual university online courses. And so you access it. And it's a lot of it's what you do see on YouTube. Some of it's even crazier, like that you don't see. But it's like $30 and it's called digitaltutors.com.
I mean, if you guys start doing that, I mean, we do, like I've done art classes online, I've done everything online.
Yeah, and I mean, you're gonna see it. And like this Wacom, and there's a lot of guys that have done stuff, but you know, there's programs like ZBrush, like things that people aren't really familiar, they're like modeling stuff. And to have these abilities to create a lot of things that don't exist out there, you know, like reference. Because that's really, at the end of the day, that's, you know, it's the more reference available, the more things that you're able to do.
Have you guys ever seen Nick Baxter tattoo? Ever watch him tattoo? No. If you ever get like the chance to watch him tattoo, it's pretty rad. Like I remember just getting my mind blown. One weekend, like, and I've watched him tattoo numerous times, but I never really paid attention to like his reference. You know what I mean? And he does do a lot of Photoshop and stuff, but I remember walking up to his booth and he had like a drawing board. Probably like, I don't know.
Regular drawing board.
And he probably had 60 pictures on it of reference. You know, like that he photographed himself, stuff he found online. I mean, you name it, it was just like, he was just sitting there drawing and tattooing, looking at his reference, it's like, damn, dude, like, this guy really did his homework and just, this is all my reference, and I'm gonna tattoo, like, I'm just staring at it right here and looking at it, you know? And then you can see some of the stuff. He puts it all together in Photoshop now, and it's like, it's mind-blowing, some of the shit that he comes up with, you know?
And his painting, too.
Yeah, and he's very diligent, like, but I mean, that's one person that really utilizes reference and his creative freedom to make shit look the way that it does. Like, there's a lot of people that aren't even on his level, you know? I guess, on a whole new page. But he's very, like, into reference, you know? It's pretty cool.
You guys,
Nick Baxter.
Nick Baxter.
You guys want one of those digital printed stencils?
What's that?
The stencil prints. I've actually got one if you want one of those stencils.
Yeah, we've, you mean for right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, are you gonna?
I'm gonna do a hand stencil. Maybe a couple of them. Okay. What do you mean, digital?
Okay.
I can print one if you want, so it'll take like 2 seconds.
Sure. Yeah, where's the pin going? I'll show you.
Where's
you guys have any other questions before I start making this stencil? Like just in general? Anything?
With the burnisher, what is it typically used in? Like, so let's say I go to Michael's or whatever and I want to find it. Do you know what it's
printmaking? Like, you know where they have almost like where they do like silk screening stuff and like.
Okay.
When you train
in
school,
you can die.
Right. I'm
just thinking of what department it would be in.
Oh, in art supply store.
What's that?
Yeah.
Yeah. I found it too. Like you guys.
Like where the stamps are. You know it's like right in there.
Would it be like in the linoleum, like linoleum print carving?
You know where they have like the rollers. Shit. I don't know what
yes,
like stamps
for like a
yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Sweet. That's what I thought.
Okay. I've also found them too, like depends on what art store you're going to, you know, like Dick Blick has them pretty much right next to I don't know if you guys use stencil paper, but like not for tattooing, you know, what's it called?
It's a graphite paper.
Yeah, the graphite paper. Like you'll see you'll see them in there too.
Okay. Yeah, I was just curious. I figured if you go in there and just ask them.
What's that?
Amazon.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where is that stuff?
I don't know. Anybody know where it is?
Yeah. Okay.
As far as the redemption, are y'all gonna come out with like a bigger tub of that?
We are.
Sweet.
So tell us the line of all your stencil stuff.
Okay, so
we even got it to Michael's.
No. I was gonna okay, so this was the prep stuff. Were you here when we talked about this one? And then we have the actual stencil stuff, which is the transfer solution, and then we have the spray stuff, which is the spray stuff. This is what you use when you draw them with markers. You're gonna spray it with this, and it will make it so that the marker doesn't wipe off as easy. Guys like Big Gus, Phlox, a lot of these big knees, all these guys, they absolutely can't live without Norm. Like, this is huge for them. They don't stencil anything. Everything is hand-drawn on. There is a right way to use this and a wrong way. The right way is that, and you were saying this earlier about, like, have you, you know, once you stencil something and then you put a marker on it and you spray it, it's totally fine, but what you don't want to do is be up too close. You want to you need to be back and mist it on. And because it mists, you're not spraying and blowing things off the skin. That's why it's super fine, like it can, so you can see it's, you know. So if you're like this, you know, misting it on, you're not gonna contaminate anything. And then I always like to put at least 2 to 3 coats on it. But they're not heavy coats. It's just real, you know, be like that, and then I'd wait a few minutes, and then I would put another one on, and then just depending, and then I put another one. And you can kind of feel it. If you touch it with your glove hand, you'll feel like a tackiness to it. When that tackiness is not there, it's perfect, it's ready to go.
But still don't skip the clean process, like the...
Yeah, you still want to do this, and then soap after, dry off that skin. Make sure that it's dry, and then you would go draw everything on and do all that. I could show you these while we're doing this. So this is our new marker, and I have a bunch. It was passing around. This was something that came about. So what this is, let's say you put a stencil on, and we all get it where there'll be some extra little spots. Maybe it's on a face or an extra line that you don't want, that you may feel that may confuse you or messed up. This right here will erase in detail that little stencil that you want off. If you want to, let's say you draw them with Sharpies, you're doing some background and you want to blend some stuff out, this will blend the Sharpie out so that you can
Is it like a regular marker blender?
Yeah, it's like similar to a marker blender. It's similar to a marker blender, but it's a little, the solution that's in here is designed a little bit more for the skin, so that you're not, again, you're not drying things out or messing with pH levels.
Like everybody wants to talk about what needles you're using, what machines you're using, and they forget that like one of the most important pieces of the tattoo is the actual stencil, you know? I mean, I know that sounds weird being an artist, you should be able to draw it anyways, but like we do rely a lot on the stencil because it's a comfort thing, you know? I mean, I've done plenty of portraits where you're not using a stencil, you just go for it, but this makes life so much easier. You know, and it is neglected. People skip this step and the tattoo doesn't look nearly as cool because the stencil base wasn't solid.
Yeah.
I've always believed like you can make something exactly like the picture, but it becomes yours when you make it different. You know what I mean? It's more artistic, it's more fun when you get to play with it. You'll see in a lot of my stuff too, like I use a lot of like colors that aren't necessarily there in the picture, but I'm kind of a stickler about where I place the colors, you know? And we'll just touch on it really quick.
I mean, with the biggest things
like,
that...
For example, like, if you were to cut... Can you guys see that on there? Since I'm not looking. If you were to cut this into thirds, and I teach this to all the guys in the shop, and if you, like, were to pick out some of my work, you could look at it. If you were to cut this into thirds, you could break it down even further. Since like her top is green, like, and you see just this little green strand, if you break it into thirds, you'll see green in every piece of my tattoo. I mean, and everybody, it's just an art thing, it's called rule of thirds, but I've really done it in every one of my tattoos. And you can even break it even further, you know, to where in every square, there's gonna be that color green. And I do that with every color that I put in. So if I have purple down here mixing into her hair, I'll actually have purple in her face. I'll do that kind of stuff too. DeVries does it too, but he does it because we, you know, I've been doing this for so long. You see like the background, this is something I know Mike would probably do because it's an easier way out. Green top, it's gonna make the background green, and that like gives him rule of thirds because he's kind of breaking it into those sections. I'll actually bring it into the skin tones as well. You know what I mean? But I do it with every color. So it's really like methodic and thought out. But like he was saying, it creates style too. But I over exaggerate it. You know what I'm saying? Skin tones aren't, there's no such thing as like, oh, this is flesh tone. You know, flesh tone is made up of multiple colors. You know, I have that portrait set from Intense, and it's kind of confusing for a lot of people who don't paint, you know what I mean? are do that kind of stuff because it's made to mix. It's 19 colors, but those colors turn into, you know, 100 colors because I'm mixing them in and out with each other to make more flesh tones. Like, the set doesn't work unless you have white. You know, a lot of those colors in there are made to be mixed. You know what I mean? But it's the same exact theory. Like, if you put any undertone underneath any color and then put a color over the top of it, that color you put over the top is gonna stay. You know what I mean? As long as you do it, you know, you're not waiting, you know, two sessions later. I mean, you could build it up to that. But yeah, man, if I could put pink over, or yellow over pink if I wanted to. With more sensitive skin like that, I actually prefer the same approach that I do now, where it's just I'm building it up slowly, you know? Especially with stretch marks, because I mean, like you said, you could tear that shit like really easy, but I do build it up. I'll just like hit it, I'll hit it really fast. Like, I'll just run through it. Like, hard to explain, but even, let's say I was doing this on stretch marks, I would hit it really fast with like a round needle, and I would just run it through really quick just to break the skin open. And then I'd do it again, go in the opposite way. And then I would get my whole thing mapped in with like a round, but it's like really soft. Like I'm talking barely touching the skin, and you can see like the stipple all over the tattoo. And then I'd go back and then start building it up slowly with the bigger needles. You know what I mean? And just keep building it up. That way those stretch marks, you know, have time to calm down a little bit. You know, because sometimes, you know, when you're tattooing, you can tattoo like a laser printer, start to finish. But doing it that way on stretch marks is extremely hard, you know. This way it makes it a lot easier because you're just feathering it, you know. It's gonna take a little bit longer, but sometimes like you can see it. I notice like under the arm, it happens a lot. You know, especially with like the skin's a little more sensitive, you just have to be more sensitive when you're doing it, you know. Those areas are definitely not areas that you wanna pound lines in. You know, like if you're, let's say it's an outline under the arm and it's a soft spot, if you're drilling those lines in, they're gonna spread. So like if you build it up, like you rake the lines in, like slowly build up a line, it's not gonna spread as much.